Getting into further details in the learning methodology we use at the Virtual Submarine, in this video I would like to highlight three aspects of it. First, our philosophy when considering learning within a VR headset, using virtual reality for transformation. Second, what are the key aspects that we work with it? And third, we're going to get into a lot of little details of each of the aspects involved in our learning method. Let us begin with the idea of using VR for user transformation, for learning. In this case, we subscribe to the philosophy of post-phenomenology. Yeah, we're going to get a little bit philosophical and theoretical. You'll find references down at the bottom of the page. But the whole idea is to see VR as a technology that has the power to transform the way the user behaves, thanks to two aspects. One, what the user can do, and second, the realities that we can build and how the world reacts to the actions of the user. These ideas of the post-phenomenology school go align nicely with the usage of complexity theory when we try to understand reality. And in particular, we look into the aspect of role-playing, in which the role one plays in a situation plays an extremely important aspect of what type of behavior we should be expecting. Now this is the philosophical part, and now we need to combine it with learning. The whole idea of any training is to facilitate a user transformation from what one doesn't know to what one knows, from what one cannot do to what one can, from what one is not confident to what one is confident to do. As such, this transformation journey, we are using VR simply to enhance it, to facilitate it in a set of experiential situations. Using VR technologies for learning and user transformation works pretty well with any training that aims to change behavior in an identification or even internalization way. In other words, if you want the user to develop a gut feeling about a specific skill. So how do we do all this? We can look at it from three layers. The first layer is the learning journey. It's the collection of simulation that slowly or gradually facilitate the user transformation. The second layer is the actual simulation in itself. Is what happens in this space, how is the world reacting to the user, and what are the actions of the user that contribute to this gradual learning process. And the last aspect is the gaming aspect. How do we make the whole experience engaging, challenging, and contributes to results? That at the end of the day is not just fun, but it's actually delivering the learning that we are aiming to do. I'm going to get a little bit more into detail into each of the layers that I just described. Let us begin with the learning journey. I think the easiest way to visualize it is if you picture the Kubler-Ross model of change. I think pretty much any change process that is currently applied within an organization, such as the Kotter 8 stages of change, gives you a good idea of the milestones necessary to drive change. So we take this as an inspiration, and we need to enhance it with a much more closer look into skill development. As such, we combine it with the views from the Dreyfus model of skill development and the Bloom's taxonomy of actions. And together with these three, we develop a theoretical framework of what should be the stages of user transformation and activities needed so that you can really provide the learning you're aiming for. The last bit of the question is we need to decide what type of situations is, what type of problems we need to put. This from a storytelling perspective. So for this, we use the Cinefin model of situations, the one that describes that there are obvious problems all the way to complex or even chaotic situations. And using this granularity of complexity, we build an engaging, challenging, and rewarding experience for the user as we move them from very obvious situations and they learn the key concepts all the way to complex situations that they get challenged and practice on it. Now, when it comes to the second layer, which is the user experience, now this is very tricky because in effect, we have the power to alter any aspect of the reality. What is the role the user plays? What is the reaction of the parties? What are the type of archetypes of the characters? What is the problem that we are trying to use? What are the actions possible for the user? I mean, there's so many moving parts, but we are not going to get into too many details about how we construct it. The key idea is that we first provide a context for the user that sets the tone, the direction. And then based on that, then the user goes and experience and practice, etc. And then afterwards, we create a reflection zone or an area for the user to digest what just happened and to gather different perspectives. We have found that this whole combination provides the biggest benefits for learning for the user. From a theoretical perspective, we really took massive inspiration from the ideas of Bandura on social learning, on the school of psychodrama, on the influence model from McKinsey, and of course the Kolff reflection learning model. So there's a lot of pedagogy ideas infused into how we construct reality. The final layer of this methodology is the usage of gaming aspects within the journey. Now, because of the type of audience we are tailored, which is a corporate world, we don't use too many of the classical gamification, the token, badges, stars. We don't use it. We try to use strategically gamification aspects that will drive learning. I mean, the most simple exercise we do is to give a grading. As a matter of fact, we notice that the user really wants to have some kind of response from the world and a grading into how good or bad they have done. And this triggers the curiosity to try to learn more. So the message I'm trying to convey is that we don't put too many aspects of gaming just for the sake of having a game. We're really looking into how we can drive learning and what is called this intrinsic motivation, reaching a stage of flow. An aspect that we have heard a lot is that they lost consciousness of time while they were getting into the game or into the game learning experience. And this is precisely what we want. The user is so engaged and learning and reflecting that by 15 minutes pass in seconds. Putting all these three layers together, we end up with a pretty engaging learning journey. And it's very practical. Most of it is focused on the idea that the user is pushing real time replicating reality situations. At the end of this journey, we are looking to a program that can be from 1 hour all the way to 3 hours, depending on the skill. We are now slowly doing testing on multiple aspects of it, and our vision is to develop this methodology further using the power of data. Per every action of the user, we can collect up to 100 different data points. And that is not only on the user responses, demographics, and learning type. We look into the way we construct the reality. And the virtual reality allows us well to get even a sense of the biometric data of the user. So you can imagine all these different data points coming together and helping us build better learning narratives. That is what we are after for. We want to really harvest all this information and construct virtual reality narratives that can drive learning faster. If you're interested to know more about the methodology, I'll be very happy to have a discussion with you. And we are aiming to release our first white paper soon. So just keep in touch with us.